but life is good. Life is good for sure.
Any critique of yourself in the video game? Anything we could do better?
I just wish my jumper was a little more consistent, but maybe I got to show something in the season. We'll see, though. But maybe on this one, we can get my jumper a little better.
All right.
We'll see.
Thank you so much.
I appreciate it.
Against the Phoenix Suns. This is Kevin Harlan courtside with Greg Anthony and Brent Beer. David Aldridge will join us momentarily from the sidelines. Hey, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, Mikal Bridges is a big part of the Suns' growth into a powerhouse. Coach Monty Williams said of his two-way swing man, I believe he has every intangible, talent, and quality to be a glue guy in that starting lineup. Mikal has an edge to him. Guys respect the heck out of him because he competes every day. Kevin, I compete every time you throw it down to me.
You do. And you're a great competitor. D.A., it is an honor to be on this broadcast with you each and every game. And certainly Bridges one to watch. D.A., thanks. So the opening lineup for the Suns. Paul out there with McLemore. Then there's Ayton. Then it's Mikal Bridges. And it's Niang in at the four slot. And for the Knicks, in the forward positions, Barrett and Randall. Then there's Emmanuel Quickley. Then it's Robinson. And it's McBride in at the one spot. And for teams already exceeding expectations, Greg, their spirits are running sky high right now.
And it's such a great feeling to come out strong. But it's hard to maintain that consistency. The teams that do, they believe in themselves and they keep playing to their strength.
And so off the tip, it's New York. Bridges against Barrett. It's blocked, and he gets it back. Shoots over Bridges. Can't get it to go. He's taken two and missed two. Down low, Niang passes to Bridges from the arc. And no good. So New York will take it the other way. This game coming on the heels of their win against the Kings.
Well, they came into that game looking to be physical, looking to control the boards, and they succeeded.
Well, the last time it was about feeding off of the glass and getting rebounds to ignite the offense, and that came up big for them. Great opportunities to get out and run.
And it's always nice to get the easy look inside for your first points of the game.
To the paint. That's good from Randall and the assist from Barrett.
The strength and the quickness and now the confidence coming along as Randall's able to score.
Paul goes in and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. It's on Mitchell Robinson.
And with Chris Paul, he makes this team work. Gets the most out of his teammates. and has done that wherever he's played.
And that one falls for Paul. As you said, Paul's teams often overachieve in the standings.
People still underestimate his impact. Sets up and improves his guys as well as anyone. And he's the engine to this whole operation.
And that's good as he hits both of his shots.
Now, there's been a lot of stops in CP3's career, but there's been no doubt when he's on the team, he is the vocal and emotional leader of their production.
Now, here's Quickly. Really played well against Sacramento in his last outing. Count it. Quickly's got his second bucket tonight.
And getting after it on the offensive glass and adding to that early total with the putback.
Sometimes guys come in with a great mindset trying to push the action until somebody stops it. Nobody there to do it that time.
Shot's good by McLemore.
Chris Paul at his best right there on that kind of play. A legendary distributor who spots the open man.
Here's the pass to Quickly. And they wasted no time getting those 3 points back. Quickly's got 7 points in the game.
He's knocking down most everything, guys. 3 of 4 here.
Paul passes to Bridges. Wow, came this close to a 4-point play. Led to the line for 3 free throws.
Second team foul.
Well, Bridges doing a good job fighting shooting hard past the foul, even Mikal after the Bridges. Release.
And with Mikal Bridges, he's a player who knows his role and plays his role as well.
I think he's one of those guys who comes from a great system. He came into the league with incredible discipline and incredible awareness of where it is he can impact the game. And that's why you see the 3-and-D effect that Mikal Bridges has had on the NBA.
And that one falls for Bridges.
Mikal Bridges, I think one of those talents coming out of college where a lot of teams expected him to have a 10 or 12 year career playing a great role as a two-way player in the NBA.
And the second free throw, good. And he makes all 3.
And at the line, it's all about consistency with him. His routine, his stroke, it never wavers.
Quickly the pass to Robinson. A good finish at the rack off the slick feet.
I think Mitchell Robinson getting more and more comfortable with plays like this. Contact on it, still able to finish.
And McLemore kicks to Bridges. Now here's Paul. D right on him. Yep, Chris that Paul. One goes. Paul's got 6.
Chris Paul knows exactly not just who's going to hit him, but how they're going to hit him.
Pass to Robinson. Inside. Here's Quickly. And that's good. Robinson picking up the assist. He's got 9.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
Now here's McLemore. Last game we saw him score 14. And out of bounds as the Knicks gain possession. And now another look at that mobile one block defensive performance.
And making a statement right away, letting them know they won't get any easy ones when he's around.
And Barrett has got the ball here for New York. Pass to McBride. Randle is doubled. He dishes it to Barrett. Randle kicks to Quickly. And again, New York with the triple.
Wow, unconscious has he been this quarter. They're riding that hot hand.
Ball against Randle. Paul dishes to Bridges. The feed now to Ayton. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
The big man coming with an attacking mindset. That's something for the defense to deal with, and Ayton is dealing.
Here's Barrett. Nice to the hoop. And the call on the shot sends him to the line.
That's his first personal. First team foul.
And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Knicks.
Guys, right from the start, it's been apparent they're determined to establish a presence in the paint.
Take a break.
I'm loving
take
the ping pong action two of shots. The ball tonight. A decent number of assists so far.
And that one falls for Barrett.
Well, RJ, another one of those players who grew up around basketball as his dad, Rowan, played overseas for the early part of RJ's life, and that introduced him to the game.
He doesn't get the second one. Ayton is a player who, Greg, occasionally shoots a three, but it's still a developing part of his game.
Yeah, you know, not the best numbers from outside. Does it to keep teams honest, but it's a far-fetched to say he can stretch a defense.
Here's McBride after Mikal Bridges' bucket. McBride passes to Robinson. Here's McBride. Six to shoot. Back to Robinson. A slam dunk by Robinson.
He's just too big and too athletic to be given that kind of position. Mitchell Robinson, an easy deuce.
Here's Paul, and the Suns tack on two more.
And you see the ability to rise and fire from mid-range, even against that length.
I don't think he sees any kind of defense when he's at that range. It doesn't matter who's guarding.
Now, here's Barrett. Boy, that win against the Kings. He's another guy who really showed up to play. Here's Quickly. And again, it's New York.
He's got a lot to do with the position that they're in. A very smart offensive performance tonight from him.
And here is Paul. 23 points his last outing. Bridges inside the three-point line. Hits the front of the rim and out. To the inside. Here's Randall. Good, and the assist goes to Robinson.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Now here's Paul. He's got eight. Poked loose. Passes to Ayton. And Ayton gets double teamed. Paul for three. Another three for Phoenix.
Good tempo on that play as Chris Paul was in place for that jumper.
Bridges against Barrett. He feeds it to Randall. The pass to Quickly. Shot from 12. And again, it's New York.
He doesn't look satisfied with the lead right now. He wants more, and he looks like he's going to get it.
Suns trail by four. And the Suns call their first time out of the game.
And one thing that separates Randall from other guys, his size, that spin move. He can do it off the drive, in the post, now going either direction.
Make some noise for T-shirt time.
And the Suns here with a different look. Here's Mulder. Taking a look at his numbers, he averages about 7 points a game. Thompson right side. From deep, McLemore. And again, it's the Suns missing. The Knicks leading by four. Here's McBride. 8 points his last outing. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
Not the kind of aggressive defense they need to cut into the lead.
Yeah, you have to protect the rim, Greg, a little better.
Good job to recognize the opportunity. That's just very solid offense.
And again, it's the Suns missing. And whirling around the floor, Greg, is there anyone Randall reminds you of?
I mean, they're different players, but Akeem Olajuwon had an unbelievable spin move. Takes a lot of body control, especially for taller guys. But when you do it well, man, it is tough to stop.
Just four to shoot. And it's quickly missing. Suns trail by six. Mulder, the pass to Finney-Smith. Here's Mulder. No good off the back of the rim.
That's one he knows he should have drained.
Toppin passes to McBride. Pass to Quickly. From outside, off the mark. The Suns have gone 7-13, just over 50% from the floor.
Some good ones.
And then Smith with the dunk.
So far, both teams scorching the Nets. You gotta love it.
Yeah, made for TV game here. Pace is great. Scoring is coming in bunches. And both of the teams feeling confident right now.
Here's Grimes. Oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. Mulder, the pass to Finney-Smith. Here's Mulder. And it's blocked.
He's not very hard to defend right now. This is when the defense might step back and let him try to find his range.
Here's Grimes, and he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight. Jackson Hayes, he's checked in for the Knicks. LaMarcus Aldridge, he's checked in for the Suns.
One shot.
Suns trail by seven. Here's Mulder. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Aldridge, the pass to Mulder. Out to the right wing. Shot clock at six. Here's Finney-Smith. And he's way off from outside.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin. Particularly here to start the game.
McBride passes to Hayes. Grimes guarded by McLemore. And the call will be against LaMarcus Aldridge. That's his first foul.
Personal. Third team foul.
Suns on defense. 7-point differential.
2 minutes. Right
to Hayes.
2 minutes.
Down to five on the shot clock.
And despite that miss, a strong start for them offensively. Oh, big time put back there. What a great motor on this guy.
There is no one who goes after those rebounds harder. There's 1:38 left to play in the first quarter. Some nice ball movement here by the Suns. The offensive rebound. They shoot again. It's deflected. Hayes, covered by Smith. Bucket is good. And now it's an 11-point Knicks lead.
They've wasted no time settling into their offense.
Smith kicks to Finney-Smith. On deep, McLemore. Kept alive. Here's Smith. No good again that time. The Knicks leading by 11. Covered by Smith. Hayes up top. To the middle. And McBride gets it to go.
Defensively, they've been a step slow here to start.
Phoenix has gotten just 2 of 6 to fall from three-point range so far in the first. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Pass to McLemore. And he uses the glass on the layup. McLemore's got five.
Now there's some easy offense there. Keep finding looks in that area, and their shooting percentages tonight are going to be off the charts.
Here's Finney-Smith, and he caps off the fast break with a monster slam.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
And the gamble paying off.
Here's Grimes. And so it's New York in control with a 9-point lead to end the quarter. And they've done a phenomenal job down low. So many of their points coming right at the rim. Back to the action after this word. One of the game's most electrifying dunkers is Obi Toppin. As he explains, the apple didn't fall far from the tree.
My dad's nickname is Dunker for Life, so he had a lot of trick dunks. Maybe I might pull out one of his dunks. We'll have to see, but he definitely had some tricks back then. I think I have better ones now, though.
He might, but Toppin's dad, a streetball legend, Greg, in New York City.
And I'm sure he's proud to see his son carry on that legacy in the NBA. Not only that, but playing for their hometown Knicks.
And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in a second. And what stands out to you from New York in this one?
Boy, their offense looks really good when everyone's in sync. Terrific first quarter.
They couldn't ask for a better one right now. Just a complete rhythm by all the guys who got some minutes. Wonderful start.
On the court for the Suns, we've got LaMarcus Aldridge, Poe out there with Smith. And it's Mulder in at the two double.
RJ's movement right there did a great job of keeping the defense off balance. And he worked to create that opening.
And he recovers it. Aldridge, the pass to Paul. Six on the shot clock. The Suns need to get a shot off. Mulder misses.
And hard work on the glass once again, guys. And they put a lot of effort and focus on the backboard.
Kicks to Barrett. There's the drive. And Hayes throws it down.
That's what he gives you, a big-time presence on the glass.
And you know what, Greg? Once he gets his hands on it, he's not even thinking about kicking it out.
Well, his competitiveness right now is why the teammates love him.
And that one, good.
Great size and great balance for a big man. Aldridge does a superb job of finishing through the contact.
McBride passes to Hayes. It's Barrett on the wing. From the baseline. Not his night so far. That's miss number five with no makes. Paul passes to Mulder. And here's Smith. Here's Finney Smith. Now Paul unloads from 13. The rebound by McBride. McBride's got four rebounds now tonight. Barrett wide open. He fires. Drills it from outside. And the Knicks lead by 12. Greg, you played on one of college basketball's all-time super teams. Hard to imagine we'll see that kind of dominance over several seasons like you guys had at UNLV.
It's true, and we still see dominant teams, but, you know, the difference is now the most talented teams tend to only play together for one season, and so that makes it really hard to run together stretches where you can call yourself a legitimate dynasty. But I still love where our game is and look forward to watching these young men chase their dream.
Mitchell Robinson's checked in for New York. Ando comes in for Toppin, and the shot is good. Ayton's got his second bucket of the game to go.
Defense unable to stop DeAndre Ayton that time, getting inside and using his frame.
Here's McBride. A look at his stats. He averages a bit over 8 points a game.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flame.
Yeah, he's the guy that you want to go to right now, trying to put this one away.
Now here's Paul. He's got 11. Passes it to Ayton. And Ayton gets double-teamed. Paul for three. No good that time. The Knicks go the other way.
Just cannot get anything to go. If there's going to be a way to get out of this hole, I don't think he'll be the one to do it.
And Matador defense, that's one of the easiest shots he is ever going to see.
Yeah, feels like Christmas right now, just gift wrapping points.
And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Thank you, guys. We have seen today's athletes taking stands for social justice. All-star Bradley Beal says, "We understand there will be a backlash, but we don't care about that. I'm a human being, a citizen, just like everybody else. I have family and friends still living in those environments, and I'm their voice." Kevin?
All right, David, thank you very much.
And they're passing the ball very crisply here.
Paul against Robinson. Paul passes to Ayton. Good, and Paul gets the assist. Paul's got three assists now in this one.
Yeah, Ayton just swallowing up the defender there and then completes the play.
Inside. Here's Barrett. Lands soft on the front of the rim and drops. Barrett's got his second basket of the night.
Yeah, he's got to knock that down if you give it to him. Uncompetitive there defensively.
The defense also looking defeated. The lack of hustle is driving the coaching staff a little bit batty right now.
Now, here is Robinson. 14 points, their largest lead in the game. McBride passes to Barrett. With the drive, and Barrett slams it in.
RJ does such a nice job of just changing speeds out there. And when he does that and picks the right angle, he'll score.
Here's Mulder. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Gets it to go from beyond the arc.
Such a critical part of how their offense is going to flow. Things are only working when he seems to be on the floor.
And the Knicks decide to take their first timeout here.
Well, whether things are good, bad, or indifferent, coaches will have adjustments to make throughout the course of the game.
Yeah, not just there to pump up or to discipline players. You got to make sure that the coach makes the proper adjustments and has his team in the right mindset to carry it out.
And New York making a change here. Quickly's checked in. Here's Quickly. He's got 16. Driving to the basket. New York needs to get off a shot. Three-pointer, Randall. It's rebounded by McLemore. Suns trail by 13. Niang kicks to Paul. Just five to shoot. And Phoenix with another turnover here.
And Chris Paul still a great defender. Fantastic positioning.
Well, not only the positioning, but if you watch Chris Paul, he's calling out every option of every play that every offense is running in the NBA. That kind of intelligence gives the rest of his group incredible confidence. And from the very beginning, Chris Paul has been one of the most disruptive point guards defensively the league has ever seen.
And the pass to Bridges. Nice ball movement by Phoenix. To the paint. He kicks it to McLemore. Pass to Niang. Back to Paul. From deep. Another three for Phoenix.
And they are absolutely stroking it from beyond the arc.
Here's Barrett. Here's Randall, and Randall throws it down.
So active and understanding more and more with his experience where to be to get offensive rebounds is Julius Randle.
Paul passes to Niang. Back to Paul. There's the triple. It's rebounded by Quickly. The Knicks leading by 12. Pass to Barrett. Grimes guarded by McLemore. Grimes and the layup is good. He has five.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Quickly against Paul.
Pretty much count on double-digit assists from Chris Paul, one of the best passers in league history.
New York's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. Down low. Great pass to set up the lay-in.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Now here's McLemore, guarded closely. Here's Thompson, and a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. Thompson's got his second bucket of the night.
Not easy to prevent Tristan Thompson from scoring in that position. Got to try to body him up.
Passes it to Randle. Bryant, guarded by McLemore. And Thompson sends it back.
Shooter just can't help but throw that ball into Tristan Thompson's hand.
Knocked loose. To the inside. Barrett. And Barrett slams it in.
Excellent on both ends of that play.
Yeah, the steal was sharp, but the slam topped it off.
And we say it time and time again, so I'll repeat it. Have to be careful with the ball, or this is what happens.
It'll go, and the Knicks lead is cut down to just 12 points on the bucket from Chris Paul.
Well, you know CP3 can get others involved, but when he wants to score, he can do that too.
New York calls timeout. As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to map out some plays for the next few minutes and a chance for the players to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's important if they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, you have to stay hydrated.
Smith checked in for Phoenix. Dorian Finney-Smith comes in for Mikal Bridges. Quickly with it. 16 points for him. To the right side. Fades back. Off the left rim and out. And it's Thompson with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Phoenix Suns. Down by 12. Here's Paul. Can't cash in from close range. New York's gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. Toppin dishes to Barrett. Quickly against Paul. Just five on the clock. And it's quickly missing. Suns trail by 12. Smith the pass to Paul. Back to Smith. And Smith with the stop.
Oh, reversed it home. That was pretty.
Agreed. The agility on display. There's 49 seconds left in the first half of the game. Smith against quickly. Now here is Smith. 6 points for him. Paul with the bucket.
Moving it around. Eight of their last 10 coming off assists.
The Knicks leading by 8. And here's Barrett. He's got 10. Now McLemore. Thompson in the corner. And McLemore kicks to Finney-Smith. The pass to McLemore. From deep three-point range. And the last-second attempt does not go in for him. And so it's the New York Knicks in the driver's seat. Up 8 points at the end of the quarter. Their shooting has been the big key. Their percentage from the field so far has been terrific. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, Coach. This team is still developing. What do they need to do to really reach their max?
Just keep working every day. Give maximum effort, great concentration, and play to win. Make winning plays.
Sounds simple, but I know it's not, Coach. Thanks for your time. Back to you guys.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody. Good to see you back here on our halftime show. Well, actually, we can't see you, but you can see us, but you get it. Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal. You're watching the NBA on 2K Sports. New York came out ready to play. Their biggest lead of the opening period during a very exciting run was all the way up to 13 points. They did not slow down much, as by the end of the quarter, they were still up 11. Momentum shifted slightly in the second quarter, causing them to lose some traction, but they still ended the half by 8. Hey, big fella, what's your take on New York so far?
You guys know I appreciate when a team takes a commitment to attack in the painted area. When you get those high percentage looks, good things tend to happen. That's how they built this league.
And Kenny, what are your thoughts on Phoenix?
Well, the effort hasn't been there in terms of rebounding the ball. They're getting outworked in that part of the game. But you got to be more physical to turn this thing around. I don't know if they have the personnel to do that.
And that should do it. With the second half about to begin, let's send you back to Kevin Harlan. Go back to Kevin Harlan. Go. Go over there.
We played through the first half. Plenty of basketball, though, left in this one. It's been a clinic by Chris Paul.
It's something that isn't his strength, but he's done a great job of finding the open man.
Well, if we were grading playmaking today, it's an A-plus from him.
Suns trail by 8. Randall and Robinson make up the inside pair. Then it's Barrett. Then there's Emmanuel quickly. And it's McBride in at the point. So that's who Tom Thibodeau starts the second half with.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside.
Here's Ayton. Robinson with the block.
Such good instincts from Robinson there to throw that one away.
Now, here's quickly. Guarded by McLemore. Shot clock at 5. Here's McBride. Will not go. This is off the front iron. And it's Phoenix's ball. 8-point game. To the middle. And Ayton throws it down.
Well, he passes to the wide open man, Bridges, developing some team chemistry.
Pass to quickly. For 3, Barrett. Yes, it is. Score that is a bucket. Number 5 on a 5 for 11 night.
And kind of par for the course here, right? Coming through with a solid offensive game to help them get this lead.
McLemore, the pass to Bridges. Ayton with it. Picked up by Barrett.
Oh, man. Fans love that. Listen to that. I love that sound in the arena.
Ayton up there just to drop it in and take some of that rim with him.
Here's McBride. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. McBride's got his second basket of the game.
I'm not sure who was supposed to be on him that possession. I mean, apparently, neither did the defenders.
New York foul.
That's his first. And Phoenix making a change.
First team.
Mulder's checked in.
Sun substitution, Michael Mulder.
And now, let's revisit that exceptional Mobile One block.
And this is how you protect and grow a lead, by making a huge effort on that end of the floor.
Two minutes into the second half of play now. Lock at 6. Lays it up off the glass.
Man, have they been effective at getting the ball inside.
McBride passes to Barrett. Robinson with it. Looking for quickly. He gets it there. A second chance effort. And the layup is up and in. Quickly's got 18 points in the game.
Just creating havoc for the opponents the last few games.
You saw by that putback there, he's just completely locked in. They're getting full contributions from him right now.
Now here's McLemore. 5 points in the game. Fires fires the three. It's rebounded by New York. At one point, they led by 16. That'll be the first half of a two-game trip. And there's Randall on the assist from Robinson. Robinson's got his third assist on the night.
How about that? The big man, Mitchell Robinson, able to find a teammate.
Here's Mulder. Pass to Niang. Now, here's Bridges. No good on the shot. A bit long that time. Inside, Randall. In it goes for the eighth time in 10 tries.
Randall is looking like tonight he's capable of taking on the whole offensive load.
Here's Mulder. Oh, Ayton in position. And in fact, alley-oop jam.
Just great hands for Ayton to time that one.
Time call here. The Knicks decide to talk it over.
And Kevin, he saw his guys just a little sluggish out there. Oftentimes, a timeout like this allows you to kind of just reset.
Well, Marcus Aldridge, he's checked in for George Niang. Here's McBride. Pass to Quickly. Here's Barrett. Here's McBride for three. Oh, and he almost had a four-point play right there. He'll go to the line with a chance for three.
First team foul.
Mikal Bridges picks one up. And what's your take, guys, on the hustle sticks for the Knicks?
Their ability to rebound and convert those second-chance opportunities has been a running theme throughout.
They have not wasted any time here tonight. They've pushed it whenever they've had the opportunity and have gotten a lot of fast break points out of it.
And he hits the first of three. The dynamic, Greg, between players and officials is always interesting, with some players saying they think there's a lot of room for improvement. What do you think?
Well, we do see players getting teed up for simply making their case, and really the guys just want to play. So, yeah, you love to see a little bit more harmony out on the floor, and maybe we need to get those two groups together in the offseason to break bread and try to smooth over that relationship.
And he can't make it, three for three. And so Aldridge will bring it up for Phoenix. Trailing by 13. Now the pass to McLemore. Now Aldridge. Down low, here's Bridges. Takes the assist and lays it in. Picked out the pass nicely.
That's pretty steady from Bridges. Does not let the contact throw him off one bit.
Here's McBride, defended by Bridges. McBride passes to Quickly. Five on the clock. Feeds it to Robinson. Barrett for three. It's hauled in by LaMarcus Aldridge. Aldridge has got his fourth rebound in this one. Pass to Mulder. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
That's his second.
It's on Mitchell Robinson.
Second team foul.
It's his first trip to the line.
And so far this season, it's been average at best at the line. Only 71% as a shooter.
Take a break. Two shots.
The first free throw is good. Obi Toppin's checked in for Julius Randle. And then for Phoenix, Tristan Thompson comes in for DeAndre Ayton. And Dorian Finney-Smith subbed in for Bridges. And so he hits both. New York leading by nine. It's Robinson, top of the key. Kicks it to Barrett, launches it, and it's Phoenix with the rebound. Thompson's got five rebounds tonight, and the Suns miss again. New York's got fewer than half of their three-pointers to go down tonight. They're four for nine. to Barrett. Active quickly. Hogged up there for Robinson.
Oh, just a picture-perfect alley-oop. You got to love that one, Kevin.
A little surprise, Greg. He didn't go for the big slam, but it works just the same. Suns trail by 11. And given Robinson's upside coming out of college, it was a little bit of a surprise that he fell to the second round.
And he's more of a classic big that won't stretch the floor. You're not going to run the offense through him. But, boy, you can't teach size and athleticism. And that's what he brings to the party.
Now, here's Quickly. He's got 18. Here's McBride. Rebound by the Suns. Thompson's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Here's Finney-Smith. Passes it to Thompson. Robinson pulls it in. Toppin passes to McBride. Quickly with it. Offensive rebound.
Not a coach in the league would be displeased with that kind of energy and effort that Mitchell Robinson showed there.
They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Here's Finney-Smith. From deep, McLemore. No good on that one. To the paint. Back to Quickly. That 3 off the mark.
But still, eventually, you got to feel like he'll start knocking those down again.
Here's McLemore, and he banks in the layup. McLemore's got 7 points in the game.
Now that's excellent. Get the ball down deep inside and cash in on a simple basket.
Barrett with the ball. He's got 15. The shot's good from Quickly.
Watch out now that he's got his first 3 of the half.
Phoenix calls timeout.
Definitely not pleased with their rebounding at the defensive end. The number of putbacks they've allowed has been terrible. I'm sure that's what he's going to address during this timeout.
And McLemore kicks to Paul. Down low, here's Finney-Smith.
And didn't do anything fancy there, but didn't need to.
Nope, his only concern right now is getting the points on the board. I don't mean style points. Thompson with the rebound. Thompson's got rebound number 7 for him tonight. And it's blocked. Now, here's Toppin. He gives his team some nice contributions, averaging a bit over 10 points a game.
Phoenix foul. Jalen Smith. That's his first personal. Second team foul.
And Hayes kicks to Quickly. Hayes trying to break free. And Hayes throws it down.
Scraping and clawing, doing everything he can to grow that lead.
Emphatic on the putback stuff.
Team's having a tough time containing him, attacking all the way there.
Thompson finds Paul. And there's the pass to Finney-Smith. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. Paul's got his 8th assist here tonight. Quickly, the bounce pass. Hayes trying to break through. And it's Quickly missing.
There's a little bit of pressure on him, but not enough to cause him to miss a shot that's in that close. Not getting old here. Seeing him make that lead pass with perfect timing.
Now, here's Quickly. 1 points in the game. Covered by Smith. Phoenix grabs the miss.
Just not there from a rhythm standpoint right now. It's really eluding him.
Here's Finney-Smith. And they get it back.
2 minutes remaining in the third. 2 minutes.
Paul surveying the floor. over Hayes. Clock at four. Paul can't get it to go. The Knicks leading by nine. And here's Barrett. 15 points in the game. The feed to Toppin. Lays it up and banks it in. Toppin's got six.
And that's a good heads-up play there from RJ.
And the Suns call time.
And he could tell his guys were dragging a little bit, calling timeout to kind of let them catch their breath.
Who wants a t-shirt?
George Niang is checked in for Phoenix. .125 left in the third. Paul passes to Thompson. That one's not going to go. And New York will come the other way. At one point, they led by 16. Here's Quickly. And the rejection by Smith. And he recovers it. Pass to Toppin. New York moving the ball around. Six to shoot. Now Thompson. A look at his stats. He averages a bit over 8 points a game. And too much time in the lane. They get called for the three-second violation.
And to make that mistake at this time is tough to come back from.
Well, not making things easier on themselves right now, that's for sure.
Bridges is checked in for Thompson. 40 seconds left in the third. Barrett the pass to Toppin. Here's Quickly. Keeps it alive. It's good on the putback. 6 points for him.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Here's Paul. And he finishes nicely on the way.
And Paul takes pride in scoring past the defense. He's used to getting roughed up a little bit. Sometimes he causes most of that, though. True grit from the little man.
Here's Quickly. It's rebounded by McLemore. That will count. And that shot was up in time, but doesn't go in. And so it's the New York Knicks holding on to an 11-point cushion as we get ready to take a break. A good size advantage, and they'll look to increase it. We'll get right back to the action when we return. And let's go back to a terrific pass that we're calling tonight our State Farm Assist of the Game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Well, a great job with the eyes. And what separates great playmakers, as we know, is peripheral vision.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same from the first three quarters. Our fourth quarter action underway, presented by Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups. And Phoenix looking who they've got on the floor. Smith is out there with Mikal Bridges. Then it's Chris Paul. Then there's Ayton. And it's Niang in at the shooting guard position. Paul outside. Pass to Niang. Ayton with it. Now the dish to Paul. And with that one, the lead is trimmed to single digits. Paul's got 24 points. To the middle, here's Randall. And the rejection by Smith. And he's able to get it back. Another shot. Randall passes to McBride. Jacks up a three. New York, no good that time either.
He's not sure if he ran out of energy at halftime or what, but so far, just not himself in the second half.
Bridges, stolen by Quickly. And a fast break now for New York. Hayes finds Quickly. Now Hayes. Up top, Randle. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
That's his second. Well,
Randle can hold his own down on the inside with that physical frame.
At the line for New York, Julius Randle. At the line, two shots.
Free throw good from Randle.
Randle really improved in his shooting range from 10 to 16 feet last year, and that just makes him so much more a complete offensive threat in any system he plays in.
And Phoenix making a change here. McLemore is checked in. Both free throws good from Randle.
And done a much better job from the line this half. They've gotten that percentage up over 80 for the game.
Ball outside.
It's close, but, you know, didn't get on balance quick enough.
Mitchell Robinson's checked in for New York.
For your New York Knicks, Mitchell Robinson.
Paul, and oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
Love how Paul angles his body when he feels that contact and then pushes off and draws the foul every time.
At the line for the Suns, Chris Paul. At the line, two shots.
Shooting two.
That one falls for Paul.
And they haven't let points get away from them at the line tonight. That's always something that'll allow a coaching staff to breathe a little easier.
And Paul drills both of them. Here's McBride. About 2 minutes into the fourth quarter in this one. Oh, and they get in the way of the alley-oop. Not to be. Good play defensively. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. Julius Randle picks one up.
Wow, they made every free throw here in the second half.
Shooting for Phoenix, Ben McLemore. At the line, two shots.
That free throw good for McLemore. Lamore drops them both. Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Pass to Barrett. Robinson against Ayton. Now, here's Quickly. Defense right on him. Six on the shot clock. From 13. No good off the front iron.
Not great numbers, but great effort in this one. Sounds funny, but I think he's been a positive for them.
Kicks it out to Paul. Bridges passes to Paul. Dishes it to Ayton. Quickly against Paul. Bridges inside the three-point line. And the Suns miss again.
A good job by him on the glass here tonight. Plus eight in that department.
Quickly with it, now guarded by Ayton. Quickly the pass to Robinson. That one good for two. And the Knicks lead by nine.
This is what Robinson does. Puts it in when he's around the 10.
And McLemore kicks to Paul. And the Suns miss again. For New York, they've gone 1-5 from the field here in the fourth. A lot of misses, just the one make. Barrett the pass to McBride. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. It's on Ben McLemore.
17.
You know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that. That's your only option.
At the line, two shots.
And he knocks down the first one.
And good job bringing that free throw percentage up here in the second half, doing a great job at the line.
That one falls, so he hits both of them.
And one difference this half is that when they get to the line, they're converting.
Ball outside. Robinson with the block.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
McBride passes to Quickly. The pass to McBride. Pass to Randall. Over Paul. And they force the shot clock violation. Great D. Suns trail by 11. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
Pass to Barrett. With the floater, and he lays it up and in. And the Knicks lead by 13.
Sometimes with that ball, RJ can put it in some spots where the defender gets on his heels.
Bridges finds eight. Now here's McLemore outside. It's rebounded by New York. Quickly's got 10 rebounds here tonight. So active. Here's Robinson. Second shot opportunity. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
That's his first personal.
He's trying everything on Mitchell Robinson. He stays cool, collected. Collect foul shots.
At the line, two shots.
He misses the free throw.
Well, at the time, Robinson's journey to the draft was such a big story, but now the story is getting bigger as he continues to improve his game and dominate the inside of NBA play.
And he's good on the second. And so it's Paul bringing it up for Phoenix. It's a 14-point game. He kicks it to Ayton. Five to shoot. Bridges passes to Niang. Here's Ayton. Count that one as his seventh make in eight attempts. A scorching 88%.
Well, again, with that kind of size, DeAndre Ayton is going to draw some fouls and does not shy away from contact.
New York calls timeout.
And, Kevin, he saw his guys just a little sluggish out there. Oftentimes, a timeout like this allows you to kind of just reset.
Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sideline.
Hey, Kevin, well, let's summarize what Tom Thibodeau went over with his guys during the break. He said nobody thought we'd be in this position right now, and we are. He said he was proud of his guys, and he also said, now go finish this thing off and get this win. Kevin?
Okay, David, thanks. stolen by Quickley. And it's Ayton with the rebound. Ayton's got 9 rebounds in the game, getting it done. Kicks to Paul. And he drives in. Bridges against Robinson. Robinson with the block. On the wing, Quickley. That's in. Coming off an assist from Randall. Quickley's got 24.
And the coaching staff enjoying that as Randall is becoming a bit more of a facilitator.
Count the basket.
Yeah, you can see the defense broke down there, allowing him to get all the way to the hoop.
Here's McBride. Passes to Quickley. Over in the corner, Randall. Going inside. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
That's his second personal.
Gets a couple steps, and the mobility of Randall there helps to draw contact.
Julius Randall. At the line, 2 shots.
That free throw good from Randall. The Suns making a switch here. Thompson's checked in. He hits both from the stripe.
And not a single free throw attempt in that first half, but he has been far more active since the break and drawing some fouls.
Here's Niang. McLemore with the ball. Trying to get open is Thompson. That's good from Paul on the assist from McLemore. McLemore's got 3 assists now in this one. Here's McBride, quickly with a wide open look. Misses the 3. Stolen by Robinson. Here's McBride. Into the lane. Uses the glass to finish the layup. McBride's got 4 points this quarter. Suns trail by 15. On the wing, Thompson. The pass to Niang. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson.
Thompson with a nice job finding the open man, creating for his teammate.
Here's Barrett. Randall left side. Trying to get open is Robinson. They get the rebound. He gets it in there. Randall's got 10 points here in the second half.
Hard work on the offensive glass. You can see the coaching staff rise up and clap for that effort.
McLemore draws contact on the shot, and now a 3-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
That's his first personal.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Suns, Ben McLemore. One shot.
What's up?
And that one misses. The Knicks leading by 13. McBride passes to Barrett. Guarded by McLemore. Hits the jumper.
13. I haven't relied on him as much as usual, but when his number has been called, he shot well enough to help them earn the lead.
Make it 5 for 10 with him in that bucket.
And they are attacking the rim and getting great results.
New York's gotten the 3-point bug tonight. They've taken 15 shots outside the arc. 6 of 15. And they call the foul, so he's got the and one chance here to make it a 3-point play.
And since halftime, it's been much more of a struggle for them to score inside. The D has been a bit quicker to collapse when they get it down low.
15 foul. At the line for New York, Julius Randle. At the line, one shot.
That free throw good from Randall. Suns trail by 16. Now here's Paul. Floats one up. He lays it in.
Chris Paul.
Paul's got 32 points in the game.
Now super touch on the floater there from Chris Paul, fooling the defense completely and then getting off the difficult shot.
Here's McBride. Phoenix grabs the miss. Thompson's got 11 rebounds in the game. Now here's Paul. He's guarded closer. Goes back up. That one's in there. The Knicks lead is cut down to 12 on the bucket from Thompson.
Now that's what Tristan Thompson does best, just working the glass and working the D over.
2 minutes remaining in the game. 2 minutes.
Thompson against Randall. Right wing. Barrett against Bridges. Just 5 on the clock. Here's Quickly. Bangs home the trifecta. Quickly's got 6 in the quarter.
Defensively, you can't afford to give him that kind of look, especially down this many points.
Teachable moment there. Lapses like this are backbreakers.
Phoenix calls timeout. They trail by 15. 1:39 left in the fourth quarter. And now, let's take a look at the New Balance player of the game, Emmanuel Quickly.
And guys, no doubt who our pick was going to be. He's made everyone else on the court look like they're playing at half speed. It's been total domination, and you can't help but just sit back and admire that performance.
The lift he got from this home crowd has been obvious. There's nothing fans love more than getting a big game out of someone other than one of their stars. Bridges misses.
Well, that's a shot right there. He's going to hit 9 times out of 10. We just saw the 10% he doesn't hit.
Quickly. Defended by Paul. And Paul over to help. And here is Quickly. Off the mark there with the 3-point shot.
And guys, what we saw here tonight is one side having everything going for them. Huge margin of victory for New York.
Nothing like second chance buckets to pick up the scoring pace.
Yeah, it was impressive how they piled on the extra points, hitting the offensive glass, and then also winning the 50-50 ball battle.
And an important milestone for them tonight as they pick up win number 10.
And so they win their first game against this squad. It's a 2-game season series, and they'll be going for the sweep the next time they face off.
Here's Barrett, following the basket by Chris Paul. Aster Quickly. At the elbow, Randall. Puts it up from 17. That one off the back iron and out. Here's the Suns with the ball. They trail by 11. Here's Thompson. He gets it to fall. That makes it just a single-digit lead.
Well, Thompson does not mind the contact, and I think that bump sometimes even helps him focus more.
Here's McBride, defended by Paul. And so it's the Knicks with the win. A confident win and one where they clearly showed the greater effort.
Yeah, I mean, it was a solid performance, particularly here at home. I think they built off that edge of being here and playing with just a little more confidence than their opponent.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, Kevin, with Julius Randle. And Julius, you get it done at multiple ends. Where has your focus been in terms of approach?
Just taking what the defense gives him. I'm a lot more patient, let the game come to me. Don't really try to force things as much. You know, sometimes I get out of character, but the shot my heart is to let the game come to me the most.
Well, you were a big part of the win tonight, Julius. Thanks for your time. Kevin, back to you.
David, thank you as always. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. We'll see you next time.